Good afternoon, and thank you all for being here. On behalf of the Wilson Community College Board of Trustees, the faculty, the staff, and of course our students, we are welcoming you to our campus for this most special event, the induction of a new president, Dr. Jami Woods, as our sixth president. She will take the oath on a Bible, originally the family Bible, but it's still in the car. It's okay. Her son is going to hold it. Gabriel, where are you here? Oh, right up front. Good. Along with the administration of her oath by the president of the entire community college system, Dr. Cox. He's just taken this position in the state. He's not been on the job long, but his office was so nice to work with us to get him here. And we'll have a few other introductions after the oath's been taken. We've rearranged the agenda because he's on a very, very, very tight schedule. And I know everybody else has things to do, but he has to drive all the way back to Raleigh, Durham, Chapel Hill, or wherever he's going. We just appreciate him being here so much. And so instead of me giving any kind of speech, which is a disappointment to me, but that's all right. I want to let you know that our trustee, Mark Johnson, who's the Reverend Mark Johnson, is going to have the invocation for us, at which point we'll have the swearing in, and we'll just rearrange. So, everyone.
Dear Reverend Mark Johnson,
Dear Reverend Mark Johnson,
good afternoon. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for the rich history of Wilson Community College. We thank you for the leadership of all of our past presidents. Then, Father God, we ask your blessings upon the presidency of Dr. Woods. We pray that her leadership will be a guiding light for the faculty, the staff, and students alike. That she will lead this great institution to even higher heights, you being a lamp unto her feet and a light unto her path. In your Son, Jesus' name, we do pray. And everybody say amen. Amen.
Come up and join me. So I'm Jeff Cox, almost brand new president of our community college system. This is my first Wednesday on the job, if that tells you how new I am. So yeah, day five here, Dr. Woods. So I'm honored to be here. I did have a scheduling conflict, and I have to give recognition and praise to your chairman for his persistence. Because the first answer is, no, I just can't. I'd love to, but I just can't work it out. This guy. He doesn't take no for an answer. So we talked and I talked and we negotiated with the conflict I had, and we bumped everything back a couple hours so I could be here. So I really, really wanted to be here. It's an exciting time for your community and for us as a community college system. So I'm honored to be here. One of my first official actions as president of the system to be here and be part of this induction ceremony. You all know this already, but you've got the fantastic leader here in Dr. Woods. It's always an exciting time for a community when you're going through this process and finding a new president. It's a time of excitement, possibility, things to come, and I know it's going to be an exciting time. I look forward to working with Dr. Woods in her new capacity as president. So I do apologize for having to come and run out, but that's what I'm gonna have to do. So we're gonna get on with it and get you sworn in. So if you wanna step forward here. So I will read this and just have you repeat after me. I'll say aye, and then you'll tell your name, and we'll go from there. So aye.
Aye, Jami Woods.
Do solemnly swear that I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of North Carolina.
And the Constitution of the State of North Carolina.
The policies and procedures of the North Carolina Community College System.
The policies and procedures of the North Carolina Community College System.
The policies and procedures of Wilson Community College.
The policies and procedures of Wilson Community College.
And that I will faithfully and impartially discharge The duties incumbent upon me.
The duties incumbent upon me.
As the president of Wilson Community College.
As the president of Wilson Community College.
According to the best of my skills and abilities.
According to the best of my skills and abilities.
Supporting and encouraging the faculty and staff.
Supporting and encouraging the faculty and staff.
Helping every student achieve their dreams and assisting.
Helping every student achieve their dreams and assisting.
The economy of Wilson in every way possible.
The economy of Wilson of every way possible.
By being cognizant of the needs of the area.
By being cognizant of the needs of the area.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Certainly feel and know every one of you is special in our hearts and in our community. We don't want to recognize, as we usually do, just a few people, and we may not do it by name, but by position. And so I would like you to know that not only did we have President Cox here, but we have several other folks who have come a long way to be with us. I just came from Hermitage Road, so I didn't come very far. They did. And we have our community college trustees, who looks like most are sitting in the front. If you would just stand up, they won't remember your name, but they'll know you're here. These are some of our trustees. We have almost all of them. Our vice chair is out of town right now, but these are the people who guided the selection of our new president, as well as many of you who we owe a debt of thanks to. You cooperating with us, you came to the Del Mastro auditorium, you sent in your comments. This was truly a community pick, not a board of trustees pick, a community pick that many of you sent notes and said you need to consider this person, that person. We put them all together. We didn't just throw them in the jar and pick a name. I mean, she was the top pick, and we are so pleased to have you here. And so I want to thank all of you for being here, because you, many of you, play an important part. I recognize a number of you having been in the selection process on the auditorium, which started way back last fall, whether August, September, somewhere in there, and continued on through this year. So when people say we have a community college, we truly do have a community college. We also have a number of community college presidents. They're sitting in the back. And if you would just stand up and tell us who you are, we only have the three.
Rusty Hunt, the door community.
Rusty Hunt. We had a couple others who were here. Also, Dr. McLeod from Edgecombe, and I think there was a third one. But schedules are schedules as they are. That's all right. I wanted to also include Foundation Board of Directors. The Foundation is so important, they raise our money, along with Wilson County and any other state, the federal government. I think maybe the city, if they don't, they might want to give us some money sometime. But we have Foundation Board members. Board, would y'all stand, our Foundation members? Very good. And we have Matt, who's going to be speaking to you in just a minute. He's the chairman. We have elected officials, which we're always tickled to have the elected officials who you helped elect. And we'll be hearing from the mayor in just a second, but others, I know Tom Fowler was here, he had to leave. They're moving his son to a different, I think, apartment over in East Carolina. But what other elected officials do we have? We have Mr. Derek Creech, Councilman Creech. We thank you for being there. Hello, and our board chairman of the school board, Ms. Fitch. She's here in the back. We thank you both for being here representing your groups. If I forgot somebody, I apologize. Knowing me, I probably did. But I would like to go ahead and get started down on the very brief program and get Matt Whitley to come up. representing the foundation. He gets to go ahead of the mayor. He didn't want to go after it.
No way. Dr. Woods, I feel like we've already had the grand finale, right? With the induction, and I'm just a firework, right? But it is my honor to stand here and represent the Foundation Board of Directors. It is our responsibility and our great honor and privilege to be able to provide scholarships for your students and your administration students. And we look forward to working with you. Only the sixth president to be inducted at Wilson Community College. So we look forward to what the future will bring and certainly welcome you to Wilson on behalf of the foundation. Thank you.
And next we have our new county manager as of a few months ago, Ron Hunt, if you'd come up. And after Ron will come the mayor.
Good afternoon. I'm glad he came before the mayor. He is literally my next door neighbor, and we only get to see each other at these events. Dr. Woods, on behalf of Wilson County Government, our Wilson County Board of Commissioners, and our board chair, Rob Wyatt, who could not be here. He is at a grandson's kindergarten graduation, which is really important today. We welcome you to Wilson County. You joined our Board of Commissioners this past Monday night. We're thrilled to have you here. And a few weeks ago, when you were in my office, you'll recall we talked about the collaborative spirit of Wilson County. And I would just go a step further today and say it's much more than a spirit. It's collaborative action. And that is what you're among today. I was born and raised here. I am a product of our Wilson County schools system and a product of our Wilson County's educational system. And this institution is the best in the state, and I'm so proud to be a part of it, and we're so honored to have you here. So take a moment today, look around at the faces. These are real people, some of the nicest people you will ever meet, and Wilson County welcomes you with open arms. So on behalf of Wilson County Government, you know where I am, you know where to find me. I'm sure you'll be asking for some money. And that's okay. So welcome.
Over 10 years.
Over 10 years. So
certainly has a wealth of knowledge of the community college system. But this brief letter I just want to read to you, and I'll give it to you. Dear Dr. Woods, I am happy to extend my sincerest congratulations to you on being named the sixth president of Wilson Community College. This is an outstanding accomplishment, and I join your family, friends, and colleagues in wishing you continued success as you step into this new position. Please contact my office if I can ever be of any assistance. And again, congratulations, Senator Tom Phillips. And I've included my card in here. Please call me, text me, email me if there's anything that we can do to assist you. Thank you.
For all the greeters, we thank you for being here. For all the guests, we thank you for being here. But there's one person we do need to thank who really doesn't get much thanks from this group because we don't think about it. We just know she's there to plan things. She has her own staff. And, of course, all of the folks who work here know who Miss Tracy Lane is. Tracy, where are you? Yes, Tracy. Say anymore other than break out the food. Thank you so much. Except Jamie's going to say a few words. Don't get up there again.
First of all, I want to thank the Board of Trustees for this event and for your warm reception, for our college employee family who's done so much to make this a wonderful day for me. I appreciate that sincerely. The wisdom and the good words of our illustrious panel, I appreciate you all making time to be here today and speak to us. Colleagues from the system, of course, Dr. Cox and our other presidents who were kind enough to make this trip. Also, I introduced several of you to my family, but I couldn't possibly make the rounds. They were traveling in, had to do a little sprucing up, so I want to ask them to stand and give you a jaunty wave. I have my son, Gabriel Erder, my nephew, Jay Woods, and my brother, Joel Woods. So, so much to me to have them here to celebrate this for our college and for my time today. And frankly, I want to thank everyone in attendance for the warm welcome, both internally at the community college and externally. I couldn't have asked to be more embraced in this community, and that just makes me feel so inspired. I want to talk to you about a few critical comments that I think are where our path is forward, and they really come down to two key words that I see being our next chapter, and they're investing and they are engaging our students. So when I think about investing, I think about reinforcing to our students how much the value of education is going to mean in their lives. And I know that's work we do every day, but reinforcing that with them and letting them know that that is education is going to pay dividends for the rest of their lives. It is a lifelong credential that no one can take away from them and that can really elevate their lives. And not just the financial impact, and I know I'm preaching to the choir, but if we do education correctly, we empower people with critical thinking skills, we make them savvy consumers of information, we make them leaders in their community and people of service. So I want us to really double down on our work with investing our students in their education, and all of our students, students from all backgrounds, socioeconomic, racial, cultural, townships that maybe we feel like we could be doing a deeper dive into serving them and maybe haven't served as much as we would like in the past. So in addition to reminding them of that credential being lifelong currency, we want them to think about its power to elevate their lives, the lives of their family, and their contribution to our community. The other thing I want to reinforce that we all know is that when we ask our students to invest, a lot of times they are making a tremendous amount of sacrifices for that investment, sacrificing time with their family, resources, all the challenges, the myriad challenges that they face to pursue their education. So I challenge us all to be equal partners in that journey with them, that we support them to completion, And that we never underestimate how the right word spoken in the right time can be that word of encouragement, that beacon that gets our students to finish. So I don't want us to ever forget how important that role we play is in getting that student to the finish line, navigating that and supporting them with that. And also while we're asking our students to invest, we're gonna invest ourselves. I know this is a hardworking community, hardworking community college, but we're going to challenge ourselves to dig a little deeper, to go a little further, to think about that customer service, that high touch interaction with our students, challenging them, but supporting them and making them believe in themselves. So I know that investment is there. We're just gonna double down on it and dig deep and make good things happen for our students and create that environment for success. Likewise, we are going to elevate. We're gonna ask our students to elevate themselves and not just meet their goals, but to surpass them. And we wanna plant the seed in our students that this is just one stop along your way. If you thought you're here for short-term training, we're gonna do our best to get you go for the diploma or the degree. Maybe you got your two-year degree and you need a certification that's critical to your field. And likewise, maybe you've always wanted to go to a four-year school and you need to get your transfer degree with us. So we're going to instill lifelong learning in our students, and we know that's going to position them for success in the world of work to come. And likewise, we're going to elevate the college. There's a famous quote about standing on the shoulders of giants, and that certainly applies here with our many past illustrious boards and leadership and faculty. But they wouldn't want us to be complacent. They wouldn't want us to rest on our laurels. They would want us to challenge ourselves to grow and to advance. So we can grow enrollment. We can have a bigger footprint in our county. We can do a lot to improve the quality of life in Wilson County for our students and our citizens, and we are invested in doing that. So we're gonna elevate our students and we're gonna elevate ourselves. So to close, I'm excited to be on this journey with you. The work we do definitely changes lives. It's gonna change the lives of our students and our community and our county, and I'm just excited and passionate about engaging in this important work with you. And thank you in advance for your support and your graciousness toward me. It's been much welcome, so thank you.